When a show is on as long as Happy Days, interesting things happen. Bicycles are replaced by cars. Girlfriends and boyfriends are replaced by husbands and wives. Pimples disappear. And suddenly, everyone has grown up. It's amazing to remember just how much we all changed in 11 seasons and how Joni and Richie grew up from cute little kids into young adults.
Look, Joni, just go to bed, all right? Look, it's 3 o'clock.
I can't sleep until Mom and Dad get home. What if something happened to them?
Oh. Well.
Well, children, what are you doing still up?
Waiting for you.
Oh, my goodness, I had no idea what time it was.
3 a.m. You had us worried. Couldn't you have at least called?
Is that too much to ask? One phone call, a single phone call, would have saved us all this worrying. Have you forgotten your home telephone number?
Well, gee, Richard, I'm sorry. It'll never happen again.
I should hope not. You know, you say you're adults, but you show no consideration for us at all.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm sorry, kids.
Well, it's late. Go on up to your room. We'll talk about it in the morning.
The kind of parents that the Cunninghams were, as compared to Robert Young and Ozzie Nelson, we were never that way. We made mistakes in trying to raise children. The Cunninghams weren't perfect. We learned from our children as well as they learned from us. And the whole concept of the beginning of the show was such that this was basically, it started out to be the story of kids growing up, first experiences.
Kids.
Yeah, kids.
You try to save them a little hurt, you give them the benefit of your experience.
Well, they won't listen.
No, they gotta go out and find things out for themselves.
Never changes.
Children just do not listen to their parents today.
I remember the first time I didn't listen to you.
Hmm. Yeah. Oh, wasn't that the time with the girl with the big Angora sweater?
You better believe it.
I didn't think you'd listen to me on that one.
My whole life. Any time that I've been confused or a little down, maybe, like... Remember the time we were playing that championship basketball game? I blew that free throw, we lost the whole thing, huh? Well, you were right there. You were right by my side. You even offered me a lifesaver.
Yeah, peppermint.
See, all those times, I didn't need a buddy. I needed a father. And that's what you were to me. Besides, who'd want to have an old buddy when they could have a perfect father?
I always felt that, I've said before, I was looking to cast people who you would welcome into your living room week after week.
Now, you all know my cousin, Chachi.
During the fifth season, we were lucky enough to have Scott Baio join our Happy Days family.
How you doing, Blue Eyes?
What are you selling today, Shrimp?
Oh, no, I sold all the shrimp to Alfred. But for you, I got no smear lipstick. We can test it out later. Wah, wah, wah.
Shy little fellow.
I walked on the stage and Henry walked over to me and like this and just hugged me. And I thought, well, you know, this will be okay, I think.
Hey, your Fonzie really blood finally made it up to your brain, huh? I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you. All right, Chachi. All right, you've got a job. Dun-dun-dun, dun-dun-dun. I want you to have this.
An old mechanic's hat?
Don't you make fun of a historical monument. This is my first hat.
Oh, your first hat? Can I keep it?
Yeah. Boys wow. Gave it to me when I souped up my first car. What was that? It was 7 and a half.
Scott Baio was very handsome and fearless. He would do anything.
He even tried, I think when he was younger, he tried to jump off the roof of his garage because he thought he was Superman. You know, he thought he could fly.
I'll tell you what. I don't need your stinking job. I've been doing all right without it. Without you, without school, without anybody. And I'll tell you something else, Fonzarelli. I don't need your stupid cap.
Stupid cap? Stupid cap? It's a very good thing that I don't got a bad temper.
Scott, I have something for you.
How about this? You know, I always wonder what happened to this. Can I have it?
Absolutely.
Thanks, Henry.
It's a pleasure.
You know, I just wish I had something to give to you. I really do.
Scott, you gave me a lot.
Really?
I had the opportunity to watch this incredibly young, talented 10-year-old squirt come on, work with you all these, and then watch you grow up to be this incredibly older, talented squirt.
Oh, by the way, do you know that I'm an executive now? And do you know what that means? It means I don't have any more time for small talk. So this is your last chance. You're going to go out with me?
Maybe.
I'm going to tell you something. One day you're going to turn me down one time too many. Maybe? You didn't say no.
I said maybe.
Now, guess what? I got a maybe. Oh, hi. What a welcome. I think I'm going to come in again.
Erin and I had a good relationship. She and I were very good friends. We dated on and off and during the show, so that helped us also during the shows, but also made it very awkward at times.
You remember last summer at the lake when you said that because I've been chasing you since I was a little kid that I may have missed out on dating a lot of other girls?
Uh-huh.
And I said that I didn't care about that?
Yeah.
Well, I was wrong.
What?
Well, it's no big thing. I figure I'm going to try and date other girls, and of course you'd be free to date other guys. This way, we'd be really sure about each other. We'd be more confident, stronger, closer, happy. What do you think? You upset?
Upset? Are you kidding? I was going to call you tomorrow and tell you the same thing.
Boy, you're really taking this well. I thought there'd be a lot of crying and carrying on.
No.
I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
See you around. All right, I'll tell you. Joni and I have to get married. I don't have to marry Joni. I want to marry Joni. I love her.
Oh, Jesse. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, a wedding. Oh, that is such good news. Oh, Joni must be so happy.
Well, she doesn't exactly know yet. Joni, I know in my heart that this is the best thing I've ever done in my life. And I love you very much. Will you marry me?
Oh, Judge.
Oh, Judge, what?
Oh, Judge, yes!
Really?
We'll be back with bloopers, outtakes, and more when the Happy Days reunion continues.